A few years ago, I got obsessed with finding new fruits and trying them out. I would go to my local grocery store looking for new fruits that I would read about or learn about online, but couldn't find them. But that didn't stop me from doing extensive research on finding new and interesting fruit. In this fun episode of The Five, I'm gonna share with you some rare and interesting fruits from the continent of Africa. Hi, my name is Jared, and welcome to The Five, where we share five interesting things in Black culture and society in every episode. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell so you can get notified when we release new videos. Okay, if some of the fruits that I'm about to name are not rare to you because you might be from the country or you eat these on a regular basis, please don't tear me up in the comments. If anything, let me know of other rare fruits that I should probably try out. In no particular order, let's start off with number five. Number five, the aki. This fruit is also known as the Anki aki apple or ai. It is a native fruit to tropical West Africa. The fruit is a pear-shaped and has three lobes. It turns from green to a bright red to yellow-orange and splits open to reveal three large shiny black seeds when it ripens. Its inner part contains soft white to yellow flesh with black seeds. Aki can be eaten by itself or with vegetable dishes as it is done in some African countries. In Jamaica and other islands throughout the Caribbean, the aki fruit grows on evergreen trees that can reach 50 feet tall. But its seeds contain poisonous hypoglycin, which is why the US banned its importation. Time magazine has named this fruit top 10 most dangerous fruits. Number four, the kiwano or horned melon. Kiwano is commonly called the horned melon, spike melon, or jelly melon. It is an annual vine in the cucumber and melon family. This fruit has horn-like spikes, hence the name horned melon. Its ripe fruit has an orange skin and a lime green jelly-like flesh with a refreshingly fruity taste and texture similar to passion fruit. It is native to sub-Saharan Africa, but is now grown in the United States, Portugal, Italy, Germany, Chile, Australia, and New Zealand. Kiwano is a traditional food plant in Africa and as such has a variety of uses. It is one of the sources of water in the Kalahari Desert and is served as a snack or salad in Zimbabwe. Kiwano can be eaten at any stage of ripening, but when overripe, it will burst forcefully to release seeds. The fruit's taste has been compared to banana and passion fruit, or a combination of banana, cucumber, and lime. A small amount of salt and sugar can increase the flavor, but the seed content can make eating the fruit less convenient than many common fruits. Some also eat the pill, which is very rich in vitamin C and dietary fiber. Number three, you gotta try the miracle fruit. Miracle fruit is a plant known for its berry that when eaten causes sour fruits such as lemon and lime subsequently consumed to taste sweet. Common names for this species include miracle fruit, miracle berry, miraculous berry, and sweet berry. It originates from West Africa where it's called Agbayan, Tami, Asa, and Lady in their local dialects. The berry has a low sugar content and a mildly sweet tang. The small colored berry is used in the medical field by doctors to bring back the appetite of cancer patients. Historically, miracle fruit was used to improve the flavor of soured cornbread, but has been used as a sweetener and flavoring agent for diverse beverages and foods such as beer, cocktails, vinegar, and pickles. However, excessive consumption of miracle fruit can result in acidity of the body. The FDA banned miracle fruit in the 60s under pressure from the sugar industry, which didn't care to contemplate an alternative sweetener with so much marketable potential. Number two, the Sao Tome peach. This superfruit is native to the island of Sao Tome and Principe. The fruit grows on small trees. The tree grows in the wild and can take several years to bear fruit. The fruit grows on the trunk of the tree throughout the year in the wild, making it accessible to wild animals. So this fruit is difficult to get your hands on. The peaches are small and shaped like triangles. The violet colored peel reveal a texture and flavor that's similar to pears. Good luck finding these little fruits at your local market. And for the number one spot, I'll give you a fruit that you are probably familiar with by name, but have never laid your hands on. You are familiar with the name cocoa and what it's used for, but did you know that it's also a super fruit? This tropical fruit is the source of every chocolate product that you've ever enjoyed. This fruit is shaped like an American football and is the deep brown color we often associate with milk chocolate. It grows on the Theobroma cocoa tree, whose name means food of the gods. The outside of the fruit is a hard shell and has to be cut with a knife. Inside you find the cocoa bean, which is the seed part that is used in making chocolate, and the fruit, which is white colored fruit pulp, which is known as baba. The fruit part is often discarded as the seeds are more valued in this fruit, but the pulp actually has its own delicious taste. You eat the fruit by popping one of the pulp colored seeds and just consuming the pulp and spitting out the seed. If you dare to bite down on the seed, you get to experience chocolate in its purest form, which is far from sweet. 70% of the world's cocoa beans come from four Western countries: Ivory Coast, Ghana, Nigeria, and Cameroon. I hope I got to introduce you to at least one fruit that you're not familiar with. Or if you knew all of them and I wasted your time, feel free to yell at me in the comments. That's it for this episode of The Five. We'll be back with another episode in Black culture and society.